and I listen for one more sound, for one more lovely thing that the hills might say. The hills are alive with the sound of music, with songs they have sung for a thousand years. The hills fill my heart with the sound of music. My heart wants to sing every song it hears. My heart wants to beat like the wings of a bird that flies from the lake to the trees. My heart wants to sigh like a chime that flies from a church on a breeze, to laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones on its way, to sing through the night like a lark who is learning to pray. I go to the hills when my heart is lonely. I know I will hear what I've heard before.
I think we should be pleased with our efforts. Out of 28 postulates, 16 or 17 are ready for the novitiate. Let's consider the doubtful ones again. There's Ermengarde.
Reverend Mother, there's no doubt about Ermengarde. The religious life is no place for the pious.
You mean the pretentiously pious, Sister Berta. There's Christina and there's Maria.
Well, after last night, I don't think there could be any doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Berta.
Ave.
Reverend Mother, we've brought Maria. She's waiting.
Sister Sophia, the mistresses of postulates and the mistress of novices do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
I love her very dearly, but she always seems to be in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I say. She climbs a tree and scrapes her knee. Her dress has got a tear.
She waltzes on her way to mass and whistles on the stair.
And underneath her wimple, she has curls in her hair.
I've even heard her singing in the Abbey.
She's always late for chapel,
but her penitence is real.
She's always late for everything,
except for every meal.
I hate to have to say it, but I very firmly feel
Maria's not an asset to the Abbey.
I'd like to say a word in her behalf.
Then say it, Sister Margareta.
Maria makes me laugh.
How do you solve a problem like Maria?
How do you catch a cloud and pin it down? How do you find a word that means Maria?
A flimmery gibbet over the whisk or
cloud. Many a thing you know you'd like to tell her. Many a thing she ought to understand. But how do you make her stay and listen to all you say? How do you keep a wave upon the sand? Oh, how do you
loose, out of focus and bemused, and I never know exactly where I am.
Unpredictable as weather, she's as flightly as a feather.
She's a darling,
she's a demon,
she's a lamb.
She'll outpester any pest, drive a hornet from its nest.
She could throw a world in dervish out of world.
She is gentle, she is wild.
She's a riddle, she's a child.
She's a headache,
she's an angel.
She's a girl.
How you solve a problem like Maria? How do you catch a cloud and pin it down? How do you find a word that means Maria?
A flibbertigibbet,
a whirlwind,
a clown.
Many a thing you know you'd like to tell her. Many a thing she ought to understand.
Now, my children, I think I should talk to Maria instead of talk about her. I'm grateful to you all. Ave. Come here, my child. Sit down, Maria. I want to talk to you.
Yes, about last night. Reverend Mother, I was on my knees most of the night because I was late. And after you'd been so kind and given me permission to leave.
Maria, it was not about you being late.
I must have awakened half the Abbey before Sister Margareta heard me and opened the gate.
Maria, very few of us could sleep. We could only think that you had lost your way, and to be lost at night on that mountain.
But I could never be lost on that mountain. That's my mountain. I was brought up on it. It's the mountain that brought me to you.
Oh?
When I was a little girl, I used to come down that mountain, climb a tree, and look over into your garden. I'd see the sisters at work and hear them singing on their way to Vespers. Many times I went back up that mountain in the dark, singing all the way. And that brings up another transgression, Reverend Mother. I was singing yesterday, and I was singing without your permission.
Maria, it is only here in the Abbey that we have rules about singing.
And that's the hardest rule of all for me. Sister Margareta is always reminding me, but too late, after I've already started to sing.
And that day you were singing in the garden at the top of your voice.
But Mother, it's that kind of song.
I came to the window, and when you saw me, you stopped.
Yes, that's been on my mind ever since it happened.
It's been on my mind too. I wish you hadn't stopped. I used to sing that song when I was a child, and I can't quite remember. Please?
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudel, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and
string. These are a few of my favorite things. Green-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel and noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Reverend Mother, we were both singing at the top of our voices.
You're right, it's that kind of song.
And singing it always makes me feel better. Mother, where did you learn that song?
I was brought up in the mountains myself. Maria, despite what you saw over our abbey walls, you weren't prepared for the way we lived, were you?
No, Mother, but I pray and I try.
What is the most important lesson you've learned here?
To find out what is the will of God and to do it.
Even if it is hard to accept?
Even then.
Maria, the dress you wore when you came to us, is it still in the robing room?
Why, no, Mother. I'm sure that's been given away to the poor. Sister Margareta said, when we enter the abbey, our worldly clothes. Mother, why do you ask?
Maria, it seems to be the will of God that you leave us.
Leave? Leave here? Oh, no, Mother. Please don't ask me to do that.
For a while only, Maria.
No, please. This is what I want. This is my life.
But are you ready for it? Perhaps if you go out into the world for a time, you'll return to us knowing what we expect of you and that we do expect it.
But I know what you expect, and I'll do it. I promise.
Maria.
If it is the will of God, where am I to go?
There's a family of 7 children. You like children, you're very good with them. They need a governess until September.
Until September?
Captain Von Trapp expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man, and a brave one. He was given the Maria Theresa Medal of Honor by the Emperor. It was for bravery in the Adriatic.
A captain in the Navy. Oh, Mother, he'll be very strict.
You aren't being sent to his battleship, Maria. God bless you, my child.
Reverend Mother, have I your permission to sing?
Yes, my child.
I have been given permission to sing.
Brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Are you old and unbeen in your heart?
Yes, sir.
I was calling for the housekeeper and she didn't answer. Do you know why?
Sometimes she doesn't hear, sir.
I'm sorry, sir. I was answering the telephone. Good day, sir. We're happy to have you home again.
Why did the last governess leave?
Who knows? She just said, "I've had enough of this," and walked out.
Why? Did Louisa play tricks again, putting toads under her bed?
She didn't complain of that, sir.
Well, there's another one coming today, and this one can't just walk out.
Oh?
She's coming from Nonberg Abbey with orders to stay until September.
I hope you'll be at home for a time, sir.
Just until tomorrow. A telephone call. Was it for me?
No, sir. It was for Franz. Before you arrived, there was a call from Vienna, a Frau Schrader. I have the number in the pantry.
I have the number. And I shall return in about a month with some guests.
Yes, sir. Do you know how many, sir?
Just two. Herr Detweiler.
Ah, Herr Detweiler.
And Frau Schrader.
Who wanted me on the telephone?
It was the post office. They've got a telegram for you. It will be delivered at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock? Gives me 5 hours to be nervous.
With that scatterbrained boy delivering telegrams.
Well, that's one thing people are saying. If the Germans did take over Austria, we'd have efficiency.
Don't let the captain hear you say that. He didn't whistle for us when his wife was alive.
He's being the captain of a ship again.
I can't bear being whistled for. It's humiliating.
In the Imperial Navy, the bosun always whistled for us.
But I wasn't in the Imperial Navy.
Too bad. You could have made a fortune. You'll wait here.
Ahem. I am Captain Von Trapp. You are Fräulein?
Maria Rainer.
And now as to your duties here. Would you mind stepping over here? Before the children meet you, you will put on another dress.
But I haven't any other dress. When we enter the abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
What about this one?
The poor didn't want this one.
So this is what you would call a worldly dress?
It belonged to our last postulant. I would have made myself another dress, but I wasn't given time. I can make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see you're given some material today, if possible. You will be in charge of my children. There are 7 of them. You will find out how far each has progressed in their studies and carry on from there. Each morning will be spent in the classroom, and each afternoon they march. You will see that at all times they conduct themselves with decorum and orderliness. The first rule of this house is discipline.
Yes, sir.
This is your new governess, Fräulein Maria. As I sound your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You will listen and learn their signals so you can call them when you want them.
Liesel. Friedrich.
Louisa.
Kurt.
Brigitte. Marta.
Gretel. Now, let's see how well you listened.
I won't have to whistle for them, Reverend Captain. What I mean is, I'll be with them all the time.
Not on all occasions. This is a large house and a large estate. They have been taught to come only when they hear their signal. Now, when I want you, this is what you will hear.
You won't have to trouble, sir, because I couldn't answer to a whistle.
Well, that's nonsense. Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
This is my orderly, my butler. Franz, the new governess, Fräulein Maria.
Yes, sir?
That is the executive officer, Frau Schmidt. Fräulein Maria. Please be sure that her room is ready.
Yes, sir.
I shall now leave you with the children. You are in command.
Pardon me, sir. I don't know how to address you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to return this whistle, Captain. I won't need it, Captain. Well, now that it's just us, would you tell me your names again and how old you are? Now you're...
I'm Liesl. I'm 16 years old, and I don't need a governess.
Well, I'm glad you told me, Liesl. We'll just be good friends.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14. I'm a boy.
A boy? Why, you're almost a man.
I'm Brigitte.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Luisa.
I'm Brigitte. She's Luisa. She's 13 years old, and you're smart. I'm 9, and I think your dress is the ugliest one I ever saw.
Brigitte, you mustn't say a thing like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
If I did think so, I wouldn't say so. I'm Kurt. I'm 11. Well, almost.
That's a nice age to be. 11. Almost.
I'm Marta, and I'm going to be 7 on Tuesday, and I'd like a pink parasol.
Pink is my favorite color, too. And you're Gretel. Now, I'm going to tell you all something. I've never been a governess before. How do I start?
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing you have to do is to tell Father to mind his own business.
No, Louisa, don't. I like her.
What's in here?
My guitar.
What did you bring this for?
For when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Of course you sing. Everybody sings. What songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't?
No.
Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing.
Let's start at the very beginning. Very good place to start. When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you to be do re mi,
do re mi,
do re mi fa sol la ti.
Come, I'll see if I can make it a little easier for you. Listen.
Do a deer, a female deer, ray a drop of golden sun, me a name I call myself, for a long, long way to run.
Drop
of golden sun.
Me.
A name
that what you call a song? Do, re, mi, fa, so, and so on?
No. Do, re, mi, fa, so, and so on are only the tools we use to build the song. Once we have these notes in our heads, we can sing a million different tunes.
How?
By mixing them up. Listen.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
Now, you do it.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
So, do, la, di, do, re, do.
So, do, la, di, do, re, do.
Now, let's put it all together.
So, do.
One word for every note, like this.
When you know the notes to sing, you can sing most anything.
You said one word for every note.
Yes, Brigitte, I did.
But when you sing, up three notes on one word.
Yes, well, sometimes we do that. Now all together and
when you know the notes to sing, you can sing most anything.
Da,
a deer, a female deer, ray, a drop of golden sun.
Liesl.
Yes?
You don't have to say goodnight this early, just because your father's home.
How did you know my father was home?
I have a way of knowing things.
You're wonderful.
Oh, no, I'm not, really.
Oh, yes, you are. I mean, how did you know 2 days ago that you would be here at just this time tonight with a telegram for Franz?
Every year on this date, he always gets a birthday telegram from his sister.
You see, you are wonderful.
Can I come again tomorrow night?
Rolf, you can't be sure you're going to have a telegram to deliver here tomorrow night.
I could come here by mistake, with a telegram for Colonel Schneider. He's here from Berlin. He's staying with the Gauleiter. But no one's supposed to know he's here. Don't you tell your father.
Why not?
Your father's pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
Some people think we ought to be German. They're pretty mad at those who don't think so. They're getting ready to... Well, let's just hope your father doesn't get into any trouble.
Don't worry about father. He was decorated for bravery.
I know. I don't worry about him. The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you, Liesl?
16. What's wrong with that?
You wait, little girl, on an empty stage for fate to turn the light on. Your life, little girl, is an empty page that men will want to ride on.
To ride on.
You are 16, going on 17, baby, it's time to think. Better beware, be candy and careful, baby, you're on the brink. You are 16, going on 17, fellows will fall in line. Eager young lads and roommates and cats will offer you food and wine. Totally unprepared are you to face a world of men. Timid and shy and scared are you of things beyond your ken. You need someone older and wiser telling you what to do. I am 17, going on 18, I'll take care of you.
Schmidt.
I'm getting ready for bed.
The captain is going to Vienna tomorrow. I have this material he ordered for a new dress for you.
Oh, how nice of him. Even before it's made, I'm sure this is the prettiest dress I've ever had. I hope the captain will like it, because I'm going to ask him for more material.
More?
Oh, not for me. For the children. For play clothes.
The Von Trapp children never play. The captain doesn't like them to get dirty.
But they're children. They have to climb trees, roll on the grass, think about rocks and caves.
The captain says the best exercise is marching. The children will continue to march. I hope you find your room comfortable.
Oh, yes, thank you.
There will be new curtains for the window in the alcove. They will be hung tomorrow.
But these curtains are very good.
There will be new curtains.
Will the captain be away long?
I don't know. Of course he has to come home every time he hires a new governess. I sometimes think the children get rid of their governesses just because they want to see their father.
He must want to see them too.
Ever since his wife died, they remind him too much of her. You can put that away, you won't be using it.
Why not?
The captain won't have music here.
Won't have music?
And he used to love music. There were wonderful evenings here. His wife would sing and he would play the violin or guitar. But now he shut all that out of his life.
So that's why he's the way he is. But not to have music, that's wrong for him and wrong for the children too.
It will work out. The captain may marry again before the summer is over.
That would change everything. The children would have a mother again.
It's going to rain. You'd better close your window.
Dear God, I know now that you've sent me here on a mission. I must help these children to love their new mother and prepare them to win her love so she will never want them to leave her. And I pray that this will become a happy family in thy sight. God bless the captain, God bless Liesel, and Friedrich, Luisa, Brigitte, Marta, and little Gretel. And, oh yes, I forgot. What's the other boy's name? Well, God bless what's his name. God bless the Reverend Mother, and Sister Margareta, and everybody at Naumburg Abbey. And now, dear God, about Liesel. Help her to know that I am her friend, and help her to tell me what she's up to.
You aren't going to tell me, are you?
Shh. Give me understanding, so that I may guide her footsteps. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
I was out taking a walk, and someone locked the doors earlier than usual, and I didn't want to wake everybody up. So when I saw your window open, you aren't going to tell Father, are you?
Did you climb that trellis to get up here?
That's how we always used to get into this room to play tricks on the governess. Luisa can climb it with a toad in her hand.
Liesel, were you out walking all by yourself? No. If we washed that dress out tonight, nobody would notice it tomorrow. Then all this would be just between you and me. You could put this on. Take your dress in there and put it to soak in the bathtub, and then come back here and sit on the edge of my bed and we'll have a talk.
You know, I told you today I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Oh, it's you, Gretel. Are you afraid? You're not afraid of a thunderstorm, are you? Well, you just come stay right here with me. Where are the others?
They're asleep. They're not scared.
Oh, no. Look. Come, all of you, up on the bed. Now all we have to do is wait for the boys.
Oh, we won't see them. Boys are brave.
You boys aren't frightened too, are you?
Oh no, we just wanted to make sure you were.
Was this your idea, Friedrich?
Oh no, it was Kurt's.
That's it. Kurt, that's the one I left out. God bless Kurt.
Why does it do that?
Well, the lightning says something to the thunder, and the thunder answers it back.
I wish it would answer so loud.
Well, maybe if we all sing loud enough, we won't hear the thunder. High on a hill was a lonely goatherd, lay-o-lay-o-lay-o. Loud was the voice of the lonely goatherd, lay-o-lay-o-lay-o. Folks in a town that was quite remote heard, lay-o-lay-o-lay-o. Lusty and clear from the goatherd's throat heard, lay-o-lay-o-lay-o.
Oh, lady, you're the lead.
yodelay, yodeloo. Men in the midst of a tobble don't hurt lady, yodelay, yodelay, ding-boo. Men drinking beer with a foam afloat hurt lady, yodelay, yodeloo. To the lonely goat herd,
lady oodle, lady oodle oo.
Soon hum a maw with a gleaming gloat herd, lady oodle, lady oodle oo. What a duet for girl and goat herd, lady oodle, lady oodle oo. Ta-ta, lady oodle oo, ta-ta, 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 lady oodle oo, ta-ta, lady oodle oo, lady oodle oo, lady. Happy are they, lady oodle oo, lady oodle oo. Soon the duet come a trio, lady or the lady or the lay, 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 or the lady or the lady or the lay.
Franz, did you tell Herr Detweiler we're having coffee out here?
Yes, sir. Herr Detweiler's still on the telephone.
Frau Schrader?
Oh, thank you.
No sign of the children, Franz?
Not yet, sir.
Georg, those mountains, they're magnificent.
Yes, they're not like any other mountains. They're friendly. And look, that green stretch of woods over there. When the wind moves through it, it's like a restless sea.
And that sweet little village.
That's not a village. That's a town.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt its feelings.
It's fun being with you. You're quite an experience for me.
You're quite an experience for me, too. Somewhere in you, there's a fascinating man. Occasionally, I catch a glimpse of him. And when I do, he's exciting.
Exciting? I've never been called exciting before.
I'm beginning to understand you better now that I see you here. You know, you're a little like those mountains, except that you keep moving. How can you be away from this place as much as you are?
Maybe I've been searching for a reason to come back here and stay.
Georg, I like it here very much.
Max can't still be on the telephone. I know he's desperate about getting singers for his Karlsberg festival, but... You like it here?
Oh, we'd have to spend some time in Vienna. I have Heinrich's estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation now.
It is, and I'm president.
You president of a corporation?
After all, I managed Heinrich's affairs for years before he died.
I just can't see you sitting behind a desk.
Well, of course. I wear a business suit and smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, Captain. Herr Detweiler would like his coffee now.
While he's telephoning?
He just finished.
I'm sorry I took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Karlsberg Festival? The finest choral group in Austria. The greatest mixed quartet in Europe. And
the best soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. All I've got up to now is a basso, who isn't even profundo.
Max, you always come up with a good festival concert.
And do you know why? Because my motto is, never start out looking for the people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning London, Paris, Stockholm, Rome.
On Georg's telephone?
Well, how else could I afford it? Why am I up here?
I hoped it was because you liked me.
Well, of course I like you, Georg. Why shouldn't I like you? You live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max.
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking as a government official, I... Georg, is there a cathedral around here?
That's our abbey, Nürnberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good. The next few days, I have to travel through all these towns around here, listening to Zegerbunds, choirs, quartets.
You will be here for meals, won't you?
Oh, yes. It was in a town just about that size, Waltzmann, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1933, they won the festival, became very famous, toured all over the world.
Oh, yes. Whatever became of them?
By the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Georg, who lives in that dilapidated castle down there? Rumpelstiltskin?
Baron Elberfeld, the oldest family in the valley.
Oh. I'd like to meet him. I'd like to meet all your friends. Georg, why don't you give a dinner for me while I'm here? Nothing very much, just something lavish.
I wouldn't know whom to invite. Today, it's difficult to tell who is a friend and who's an enemy.
This isn't a good time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what's happened to the children.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome you.
Well, it couldn't have been an intentional slight because they haven't met me yet.
Forgive me. I'll try to find them.
Elsa, have you made up Georg's mind yet? Is he going to marry you?
Oh, yes. He hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
And you don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's very simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes. He's rich, and you're rich. Oh,
Max.
In all the famous love affairs, the lovers have to struggle. In garret rooms away upstairs, the lovers starve and snuggle. The famous form is fortune, which they seem to have no fear of. While lovers who are very rich, you very seldom hear of.
Not a sign of them anywhere.
No little shack do you share with me. We do not flee from a mortgagee. Nary a care in the world have we.
How can love survive?
You're fond of bonds and you own a lot. I have a plane and a diesel yacht.
Plenty of nothing you haven't got. How can love survive?
No rides for us on the top of a bus in the face of the freezing breezes.
You reach your goals in your comfy old Rolls or in one of your Mercedeses.
Far, very far off the beam are we. Quaint and bizarre as a team are we. Two millionaires with a dream are we. But we'll keep romance alive. Two millionaires with a dream are we. We'll make our love survive. No gold or cold water flat have we. Warmed by the glow of insolvency.
Up to your necks in security. How can love survive?
How can I show what I feel for you? I cannot go out and steal for you. I cannot die like a meal for you. How can love survive?
millionaires with financial affairs are too busy for simple pleasure. When you are poor, it is toujours l'amour. For l'amour, all the poor have leisure.
Caught in our gold-plated chains are we. Lost in our wealthy domains are we. Trapped by our capital gains are we. But we'll keep romance alive.
Trapped by your capital gains are you. You'll make your love survive. What do you want?
Heil.
Who are you?
I have a telegram for Herr Detweiler.
I am Herr Detweiler. You've delivered your telegram. Now get out!
Georg, he's just a boy.
I am an Austrian. I will not be heiled!
Georg, why don't you just see things the way I do? What's going to happen is going to happen. Just be sure it doesn't happen to you.
Max, it's a good thing you haven't any character, because if you had, I'm convinced I would hate you.
You couldn't hate me. I'm too lovable.
Herr Detweiler, there's a call for you. It's from...
I'll take it.
Oh, Captain, you're home.
Mommy, Mommy, help!
Straight line! Get cleaned up. Get back into your uniforms and report back here. At once! And Fräulein, where do they get these abominations? Out of a nightmare?
No, out of some curtains. The same ones that used to hang in my bedroom. There was plenty of wear left in them.
Just a moment. You mean to tell me the people of the neighborhood have seen my children wearing curtains?
Oh yes, they've become very popular. Everyone smiles at them.
I don't wonder.
They say, there go Captain Von Trapp's children.
My children have always been a credit to my name.
But Captain, they weren't. They were just unhappy little marching machines.
I don't care to hear from you about my children.
Well, you have to hear from someone. You're not home long enough to know them.
I said I don't want to hear.
I know you don't, but you've got to. Take Liesl. Liesl isn't a child anymore. And if you keep treating her as one, Captain, you're going to have a mutiny on your hands. And Friedrich. Friedrich's afraid to be himself. He's shy. He's aloof. He needs you. He needs your confidence.
Don't tell me about my son.
Brigitte could tell you about him. She could tell you a whole lot more if you just got to know her. Because she notices things. And she always tells the truth, even when you don't want to hear it. And Kurt is sensitive. He's easily hurt. And you ignore him. You brush him aside the way you do all of them. I haven't finished yet! Louisa just wants to have a good time. You've just got to let her have a good time, Captain. And Marta, I'm not sure about yet. But someone has to find out about her. And little Gretel just wants to be loved. Oh, please, Captain, love Gretel. Love them all. They need you.
Stop! Stop it. You will pack your things and return to the Abbey as soon as you can.
I'm sorry if I said something I shouldn't have said.
And after you're gone, there'll...
With the sound of
what is that?
Singing.
Who's singing?
Your children.
My children singing?
Yes, I wanted them to sing something for Frau Schrader when they met her.
Like the wings of the birds that rise from the lake to the
I know I will hear what I've heard before. My heart will be blessed with the sound of music, and I'll sing once more.
Edelweiss, Georg, why haven't you told me how enchanting your children are?
Children? I'd like you to show Frau Schrader the gardens.
Yes, show me the gardens. I want to see everything, and with you, too. I don't know any of your names yet, but it doesn't matter. I'm sure I won't get them straight for a long time.
My name is Marta.
It is not. My name's Marta. She's Louisa.
You were right. I don't know my own children.
They're waiting to know you. They want so much to. After I've gone.
No. I want you to stay.
If I can be of any help.
You have helped already. You brought music back into my home. I had forgotten.
To laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones on its way. To sing through the night. Like a lark who is learning to pray. I go to the hills when my heart is lonely. I know I will hear what I've heard before. My heart will be blessed with the sound of and I'll sing once more.
May a drop of golden sun me a name I call myself for a long, long way to.
I came back to congratulate you.
Thank you.
The captain was really moved.
Yes, I think he was pleased. He asked if I could stay on with the children.
Oh, you're staying on.
Only until September.
Until September?
Yes, then I go back to the Abbey.
The Abbey?
I'm going to be a nun.
Oh, how nice. When you get back to the Abbey, think of us.
I'll pray for you.
That's right, you must do that to all the guests. Come along, children, the party started.
Freshman, will you fix my bow? We've never had a party at our house before.
Oh yes, there used to be lots of parties here.
Friedrich and I used to sneak out and watch them from the top of the stairs.
I remember the music.
Once your father brought a gypsy orchestra all the way from Budapest.
They wore red coats.
Go ahead, children, and mind your manners. Come along.
I remember beautiful ladies and everyone laughing.
I remember there was one lady, the most beautiful of all.
she was here all the time.
Yes, Louisa.
Can we dance while the guests are dancing?
Of course. Remember what Fräulein Maria told us.
You have German blood, haven't you?
I am not a German. I'm an Austrian.
There's going to be an Anschluss. I warn you, and everyone like you. And that goes for our...
It is much more pleasant on the terrace. Ah, Elberfeld. It's good to have you and the Baroness here again.
Frau Schrader's charming, Georg.
I hope she isn't ill.
Oh, no. Just a headache. I'm on my way up to get her now. We'll find you on the terrace.
Father, I don't think these people are having a very good time.
Half the people I've invited aren't speaking to the other half.
Well, Father, maybe they're having a good time not speaking to each other.
Oh, sir, Schrader asked me to let you know that she will join you in a few minutes.
Well, thank you. See whether she would like this glass of brandy.
Kurt, I haven't danced since I was a very little girl.
Oh, you remember? Show me!
No, Kurt. I haven't danced since...
Come, you see the left hand behind the back.
Yes, that's right. But first the boy and girl meet. Then they go for a little stroll.
No, Kurt, that's wrong. Let me show you. Well, Kurt, that's how it's done.
Your face is all red.
I guess I'm not very used to dancing.
Well, hello there.
Good evening, Frau Schrader.
I hope you're feeling better, Frau Schrader.
Yes, thank you, Friedrich. I mean, Kurt.
Hello, Uncle Max. We're having a party.
You are? Good. Tell your father it's sure to be a success. I'm here.
Max.
Elsa, Without a doubt, you are the most beautiful corporation president in the entire world.
Thank you, Max.
Ah, Max, you're back. And as usual, just in time for dinner.
Georg, did you really think you could throw a gal out without me?
Oh dear, now we have an odd man.
Well, a little odd, but charming.
Liesl, run and ask Frau Schmidt to set two more places for dinner. And I want to see Fräulein Maria.
Two places?
We need another woman.
Who? Liesl?
Oh no, she's much too young. I'll ask Fräulein Maria.
You can't be serious.
But of course.
But she's a nursemaid.
I don't think of her that way.
Well, I don't mind, but your guests, you can't ask your guests to dine with Maria.
And why not?
Well, because she's, well, Elsa, tell him why not.
Max, can you change in a hurry?
Yes, Max, we can use you tonight.
Frau Schrader, they're talking about you out there.
Come on, Georg, I've been dodging these people for an hour.
Brigitte, have you seen your father?
Good evening, Fräulein Maria.
Herr Detweiler, it's nice to see you again.
Yes, you're going to.
I knew it all along. Frau Schrader didn't have a headache. She just wanted to get out of the party. She was baking.
Now, Brigitte, you shouldn't say things you don't know are true.
But I do know. I heard her say to father she'd been dodging these people.
That doesn't mean she didn't have a headache. It's very important that your children like Frau Schrader.
I like her, all right. Why is it important?
Well, I think she's going to be your new mother.
Oh, Fräulein, father's never going to marry her. Why, he couldn't.
Why couldn't he?
Because he's in love with you.
Now, Brigitte, that's just the kind of thing...
You must know that.
No, Brigitte.
Remember the other night when we were all sitting on the floor singing that Edelweiss song he taught us? After we finished, you laughed at him for forgetting the words. He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you. And when he talks to you, the way his voice sounds.
No, Brigitte, no!
And when you were just now dancing, you're in love with him.
One more dance, Gretel, and then to bed. Oh, Fräulein Maria, you won't be dining with the children tonight. You'll be dining down here with us. Oh yes, it's all arranged. But you'll have to hurry. You'll have to change. Maria, wear that dress you wore the other night when we were all singing. It was lovely, soft and white.
Shall I announce dinner, Captain?
Oh, no, not yet. The children will want to say goodnight. Georg, I wanted the children to say goodnight the way they did last night.
No, Elsa, not here.
Please, Georg, the way they did last night. It was so sweet.
No, no, not in front of strangers.
Please, Georg, for me.
Presto changeo!
Max, you're just in time. Children, now.
There's a sad sort of clanging from the clock in the hall and the bells in the steeple too. And up in the nursery an absurd little bird is popping out to say coo. Regretfully they tell us, but firmly they compel us to say goodbye to you. So long, farewell, our Venus saying goodnight.
I hate to go and leave this pretty sight.
So long, farewell, I'll be the same, adieu.
Adieu, adieu, to you and you and you.
So long, farewell, au revoir, I'll be the same.
I'd like to stay and taste my first champagne. Yes?
No.
Farewell, I'll be there saying goodbye.
I leave and heave a sigh and
Dinner is served.
Elsa, they're extraordinary.
Fräulein Marie taught them to do it.
I've been looking for something like this all over Austria, and I find it here.
Wait a minute, Max.
7 singing children in one family.
Georg didn't even want the children to sing for the guests tonight.
Ah, so you have influence. You must convince him.
Max.
Elsa, this is for Austria.
And it wouldn't do me any harm.
Sister Sophia, take our new postulate to the robing room. God bless you, my daughter. Ave.
Reverend Mother, Maria has asked to see you. I know it has taken her a long time.
I waited until she wanted to come to me.
It's strange. She's happy to be here, but she's unhappy too.
Why did they send her back? Do you know?
She has only spoken in prayer.
I shall see her.
Maria?
This must have been a trying experience for you.
It was, Reverend Mother.
Has it taught you anything?
I've learned that I never want to leave these walls again.
Maria? Why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back. I left. I left without telling them I was going, without saying goodbye.
Maria, sit down. Maria, what happened? Why did you do this?
I was frightened.
Frightened?
I was confused. I felt I never felt that way before. And I knew that here I would be away from it, that here I would be safe.
Maria, our abbey is not meant to be an escape. What is it you can't face?
I can't face him again.
Thank you, Sister Margareta. Maria, are you in love with Captain Von Trapp?
I don't know.
Tell me about it.
Brigitte said that I was, and that her father was in love with me. And then there he was, and we were looking at each other, and I could hardly breathe. Then I knew I couldn't stay.
But do you like him, Maria?
Oh, yes.
Did you let him see how you felt?
If I did, I didn't know that I did. That's what's been torturing me. I was there on God's errand. To have asked for the captain's love would have been wrong. I don't know, Mother, but I do know this. I am ready at this very moment to take the vows of poverty, obedience, and chastity.
Maria, the love of a man and a woman can be holy too. The first time we talked together, you told me you remembered your mother and father before they died. Do you remember? Were they happy?
Oh, yes, Mother, they were very happy.
Maria, you were born of their happiness, of their love, and you have a great capacity to love. The question is, how does God want you to spend your love?
But I've pledged my life to God's service. I've pledged my life to God.
Maria, if you love this man, it does not mean you love God less. You must go back.
Please don't ask me to do that. Please, let me stay here.
Maria, these walls were not made to shut out your problems. You have to face them. You have to find the life you were born to live.
How do I find it?
You look for it.